Hello friends, welcome you all in the YouTube channel Let's Learn and Grow Together in the course of Engineering Metallurgy. Today we are going to study the next part, and that is plotting of equilibrium diagram. Okay, so we have studied that how to plot the cooling curve. So when we are plotting the cooling curve, when we are plotting the cooling curve, in that we have seen that on x-axis there is a time and on y-axis we are plotting temperature. Suppose if we consider the cooling curve for pure metal, then that will be like this. Here from point 1, 2, 3 and 4, 1 to 2 liquid region, 2 to 3 liquid plus solid region, 3 to 4 solid region. So this is cooling curve for pure metal. Now if we plot the cooling curve for alloy, in that case x-axis time, y-axis temperature. Here the cooling curve will be like this. In that 1 to 2 liquid, 2 to 3 liquid plus solid and 3 to 4 solid. So in case of pure metal, what we can say, temperature is constant. Here we are getting constant temperature. And in case of alloy, this is alloy. In case of alloy, the liquidus temperature and solidus temperature, these two temperatures are different. Means liquidus and solidus temperature are, what we can say, different. And here we are getting the constant temperature. So in case of alloy, we are getting two temperatures, that is liquidus and solidus. In case of pure metal, we are getting only one temperature. Okay, now while plotting the equilibrium diagram, what we have to consider, that when we are plotting the equilibrium diagram, in that case what we can say, on x-axis percentage weight of solute and on y-axis temperature. Now here what we are considering, that we have to consider, we are going to consider the alloy, we are going to consider the alloy of copper and nickel. In that, what we are going to consider, suppose here percentage of copper, percentage of nickel. Now if the first solution, first solution having 100% copper, 0% nickel, second solution having 90% copper, 10% nickel, third solution 80% copper, 20% nickel, like that 70%, 30%, 60%, 40%, 50%, 50%, 60%, 40%, 40%, 60%, 40% here, 60%, 30%, 70%, 20%, 80%, 10th one 10%, 90%, and 11th number 0%, 100%. Now what we can say that whatever 11 numbers of material we have considered, that is alloy we have considered from 1st to 11, in that first number is pure metal and 11th number is pure metal, and remaining, suppose from metal 2 to metal 10, these are nothing but the alloys. These are nothing but the alloys. Understood? So we have considered this example, and now what we have to do, that we have to plot the cooling curve. Means we have to plot the cooling curves for these different types of the metal. Okay. So while plotting the cooling curve, what we are going to consider, see, as we know that on x-axis time and on y-axis temperature. Okay. Here we have considered two metal, that is copper and nickel. We have considered two metal, copper and nickel. Suppose this is the temperature line for copper and this will be the temperature line for nickel. Okay. So these are the two lines which are going to indicate the copper and nickel. Okay. Now the copper having melting point, that is, suppose if we are considering the copper melting point here, that is 1083, and nickel melting point as 1453 degree centigrade. Okay. So in between that, what we are going to consider, or what we are going to do, we have to plot the cooling curve. We have to plot the cooling curve. Now if we consider the first element, in that 100% copper and 0% nickel is there. So that will be here, that point will be here. As in case of pure metal we have considered, means suppose if we consider the pure metal, then in case of pure metal the curve will be like this. And if we consider the first element, then in that case copper is 100% and nickel is 0%. So that point we are getting here, that is here we are getting that point. Okay. Now at this region, how we are going, how we will plot that? Like this. That is liquidus temperature and solidus temperature. Now if we consider the second curve, where 90% copper and 10% nickel, so that we can plot like this. Suppose if we draw the dotted line first, that will be helpful for us to plot the accurate cooling curve. So this dotted line we have to draw at the last after plotting the all cooling curve. So for our understanding purpose, what we are doing, that we are plotting this. Okay. Now second curve will be like this, two different temperature. Third will be like this, fourth will be like this. Okay, so like that we are plotting different curves. That is, this is for metal 1, this is L2, S2, L3, S3, L4, S4. Here what we can say, L1, S1, both are same. Finally here we will plot like this. Here we can write as a L9, S9, L10, S10, and here L11, S11. Okay. So these are this type of the cooling curve we have to plot, and then what we are going to do, these points we are joining like this with the help of this smooth curve, we have to join these different points. Okay, so from this cooling curve, what we are getting, that we are getting different temperature. We are getting different temperature. And what are that temperature? That is liquidus and solidus. Liquidus and solidus temperatures we are getting. Okay. Now after plotting this cooling curve, this is the cooling curve. Cooling curve. After plotting this cooling curve, what we have to plot? We have to plot the equilibrium diagram. Equilibrium diagram or phase diagram. What we have to do, that two axes again we have to plot. On x-axis percentage weight of nickel and on y-axis temperature. Here pure copper is there. Okay. Now as we have considered 10% nickel, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 and 100%. Okay. So again here we plot this line which is having 100% of the nickel. Now this line will give the information, means this whatever lines are there, means suppose this one is the line for 10% nickel, 20% nickel, 30% nickel, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 and 100. Now here what we have to do, whatever liquidus and solidus temperature we got from the cooling curve, that we have to plot on this particular diagram. Okay. Now here we got the same temperature, that is L1 is equal to S1. Okay. And here we got same temperature for L11 is equal to S11, that is liquidus and solidus temperature of first material and 11th number of material, because these two materials are pure material and remaining whatever materials we are getting from 2 to 90, these are having what we can say alloys. Okay. Now here for our understanding purpose, what we can do, that we will plot the dotted type of the curve. Okay, so this curve we have to plot after the completion of all the, what we can say, the point. Okay, now for 10% we got L2, S2. For 20% L3, S3. For 30% L4, S4. Likewise, for 80% L8, S8. L9, S9. Okay, and here, sorry, here L9, S9, L10, S10, L11 and S11. Okay, here L8, S8. Okay, so these points we got, that is S2, S3, S4, S8, S9, S10 and S11. These points we have to join with the help of smooth curve like this. Okay, so this particular curve is nothing but the equilibrium diagram. That is the equilibrium diagram or phase diagram. Phase diagram. Here this line gives the information about liquidus line and this line gives information about solidus line. Okay, above this line, whatever we are getting, that is the liquid. In between this curve, we are getting liquid plus solid, and below this line, we are getting the solid region. Okay, so this equilibrium diagram, whatever we have plotted with the help of cooling curve, and from that cooling curve, we got the different temperature. This particular cooling curve, or we can say this particular equilibrium diagram, will give the information about different phases exist into the material. Different phases exist into the material. Then what we can say, different temperatures we are getting from this equilibrium diagram. Okay, and we are getting different microstructures for different percentage of nickel and for different temperature. Okay, so in this today's lecture, what we have studied, that how to plot the cooling curve. Okay, that we have seen the cooling curve for pure metal will be like this, cooling curve for alloy will be like this. We have considered the example of copper and nickel alloy. In that, we have considered the total 11 number of the solutions. From that, we plotted the cooling curve. This type of the cooling curve we have plotted. From that, we got the different temperatures, that is liquidus and solidus type of the temperature. After that, we have plotted the equilibrium diagram. And to plot equilibrium diagram, what we have to do, that whatever temperatures we got from the cooling curve, that we have to transfer in a equilibrium diagram. Equilibrium diagram means to plot equilibrium diagram, the temperatures what we got from the cooling curve, that we have to transfer on the x-axis, on the y-axis of equilibrium diagram. Okay, so this is the overall idea regarding plotting of equilibrium diagram and plotting of cooling curve.
Hopefully you might have enjoyed the lecture. Then please do like the video and know your thoughts in comments. Please do share this video among your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. After subscription, you can press the bell icon to never miss the notification regarding our new videos. Thank you so much.